Hello students, welcome to class 9th. I am Atulya. I will be taking your computers for this session. Now, as class 9th is completely different from class 10th, the first thing that you need to know is the syllabus of your subject. In computers, your syllabus is divided into two parts. Part A is employability skills, and then part B is vocational skills. First, we are going to cover the part A of your syllabus, that is employability skills. In employability skills, there are various units. Amongst those units, the first unit that we'll be covering is communication skills. So let's start today's session with the first unit, that is communication skills. In communication skills, the first thing that you need to learn is a communication cycle. Now, if we talk about communication cycle, the first thing that must be coming to your mind is, what is communication? Communication is the process of transferring or sharing of information between two or more people. In communication, people exchange information, ideas, news, and feelings. Scope of communication, it is not just limited to two people, but it involves the whole society. We communicate every day with our family, teachers, friends, and pets. So from this we get to know that communication is nothing but the way of sharing messages between two or more people. Like, you may be talking to your friend, you may be talking to your father, you may be talking to your mother. But these things are called communication. However, a communication always involves two or more people. A communication cannot happen with a single person. For communication, you need two persons or more than two persons. Right? Now, what do we communicate? We usually communicate some kind of ideas with each other. We communicate some news with each other, like we gossip. We share our feelings with each other. So these types of things come under communication. We also share information with each other. So these are the things that constitute a part of communication. Now, most of the people think that communication is just limited to two people or more than two people, meaning three or four people or a group of people. But no, communication involves the whole of society. Everyone living in a society is a part of whom you talk to is a part of communication. We are a part of communication every day in our life. We communicate, like I have told you before also, we communicate with our father, we communicate with our mothers, we communicate with our teachers, friends. So we communicate with someone or the other on a daily basis. The most important thing to remember in a communication is that communication is a two-way process. Like I have told you before, there are the minimum of two persons are required for communication to take place. First one is a sender and the other one is the receiver. Now, sender will send his message to the receiver and the receiver will send a feedback or the response to the sender. Now let's take an example of two boys, Ram and Shyam. Ram asked Shyam, "How are you?" So the message that is being sent is, he's asking a question to Shyam, "How is he?" And in response, Shyam said, "I am fine." So now the feedback or the response that is given by Shyam is that he is fine. So from here we come to know that communication is a two-way process. So communication is a two-way process. Now we will be talking on features of communication. A communication is a meaningful process that involves a sender and a receiver. While communicating, both should share. In this feature, the most important point to note here is, while communicating, both should share. As I've told you before, Communication is a process that involves both the sender and the receiver. Two people have to be involved in a communication. One is the sender and the other one is the receiver. Okay, the one who is speaking a message is the sender and the one who is listening to the message is the receiver. So while communicating, both should share. It should not be that one person is speaking while the other person is not responding. If the other person is not responding, then it cannot be considered as a communication. Okay, a message, the next feature is a message should always be clear and it should always be conveyed in the right meaning. It's always better to have a clear message sent out to the receiver, because what happens is if your message is not clear, it may give mixed signals to the receiver or it might be conveyed in the wrong meaning to the other person. You might be saying something in the right way or in the right tone, or you might be saying something right, but the other person, if he does not understand your message, might take it in a wrong sense. Then fights can break out, a quarrel can break out, anything can happen. So a message should always be clear and crisp. The next feature of communication is listening. Listening to others is also an important aspect of communication. Now, listening is considered an important important aspect, because when you talk to someone, you expect that the other person will give a response to whatever you're speaking. Now imagine if that person is not listening to you. If he's not listening, will he be able to respond to you? No, he won't be able to respond to you. So listening is also an important aspect of communication. If you will not listen to the person who's speaking, how will you respond? So listening is an important aspect of communication. Another feature of communication is that it is a process in which there is an input and output. So it's very clear, sender is the one who is sending an input in the form of message, and output is the feedback or the response that is being sent by the receiver. So these are the features of communication. The next now we are going to talk about is the impact of effective communication. What happens if someone starts communicating effectively? What will it do? So having an effective communication can encourage active participation in group discussions. As I've told you numerous times before, whenever you'll go out for any job interview or for that matter anywhere, if you're good in English or you're sitting in a group of well-educated, knowledgeable people, then they will be, you might be a part of group discussion in some ways or the others. So it's always better to have effective communication skills. Effective communication skills will help you in participating in, that group discussion. So the next impact it effective communication has is that it helps in building relationship with others. While communicating, sometimes what happens is you build a rapport with people. This is how you make friends with other people. So when you talk to someone, until unless you talk to someone or you communicate with someone, you don't know whether that person can be your friend or not. If he or she can be your friend or not is decided mostly by the type of response you get. Maybe you share the same mentality. And how will you guess the person standing right in front of you shares the same mentality that you have? You can only guess it by communicating with that person. So yes, communication helps in building a relationship with others as well. And it's also important to let others know what you feel rather than keeping things inside you. This fosters effective communication, also builds trust between other people. So this is how your relationship will build with others via communication. Communication helps a leader to cultivate a sense of common goal among team members. Now imagine you are a team leader of a multinational company. Now you have been assigned a project, right? And you have to complete that project in a specific duration of time. So most of your team members might feel that the time duration is a little short, right, to complete that project. So now what do you need to do? You need to motivate your team members by having effective communication with them and telling them What is the common goal that you wish to achieve? Until and unless you do not communicate your common goals, your team members are not going to work as a team, and in the end result would be your project will keep on getting delayed. So it helps a leader to cultivate a sense of common goal among team members. The next impact is that the ability to communicate helps building confidence. Oh yes, definitely. Now most of the people or most of the students say that, sir, I know English, but I do know, but I cannot speak in a correct grammatical fashion or a correct grammatical way, so I limit myself from speaking in English. Now if you start communicating in English, whether right or wrong, irrespective of that, you start speaking, it means you started communicating, and once you start communicating, it will automatically build your confidence, and you'll be able to speak a lot more freely and grammatically correct. So ability to communicate always helps in building confidence. The next impact of effective communication is that it saves time and reduces stress. Sometimes when people do not speak what is in their mind, people start presuming things. They might, like, for, let's take an example, you did something good, right? Or you don't know whether you did something good or bad, and your class teacher is constantly looking at you. So now what will happen? You start feeling stress. What have I done? Have I done something right or have I done something wrong? So you'll be in a constant stress. Now imagine suddenly the teacher says or pats your back and says, good work. So now your stress will be relieved. Okay, I did something good. So effective communication reduces stress, and it also reduces time. Let's take an example of an organization. In an organization, there's a manager. That manager wants a certain work to be done in a specific way. So what he does is he calls his employee and he gives him that work, but he does not say anything. Will that employee be able to complete the work as per the desires of his manager? No, he won't be able to do that. Now what will happen? He will do that work based on his understanding of the work. Now what will happen in the end? The manager might end up rejecting his work. So this, what is it doing? It is killing the time. So if the manager had communicated the way he wished that employee to do that specific work, then it would have saved a lot of time. So effective communication saves time and it reduces stress. Thank you, class. With this, we come to the end of today's session. I hope you enjoyed it. Very soon you'll be getting the next, I'll be uploading the next video on communication skills. Thank you so much for being here. Hope to meet you soon. Thank you, class.